Hello everyone, so in this video I'm going to teach how to save a macro enabled workbook. Now typical workbooks, typical Excel workbooks are called .xlsx. So when you save any of your workbook, you might have noticed that there is an extension to it, that is .xlsx. Maybe you have named it as my workbook.xlsx. So that is the extension which is there for a normal workbook. Now in this particular workbook, I have recorded one macro. I'll show you all. So I've recorded one macro. This is how I've recorded the macro. And so now if you are saving, if you have just recorded your first macro in your workbook and you want to save this particular workbook, so how to do that? Go to the Files tab. Or for those who have a Microsoft button over here, click on that. Then you'll have two options, to save or save as. Now if you're saving it for the first time, you can do save as. If it's already there, if the workbook is already there at the location where you want it to be, you can go for the save option as well. Both will give you the same result. So if I'm going for save as, let's suppose. Now this is the dialog box which is appearing. I can change the name. Of the workbook. Let's say suppose I'm giving it as my demo. And then save as type. In the save as, once I click, or if you just ignore this one and you click as save, there is a dialog box which has appeared which says the following feature cannot be saved in a macro free workbook. So this is an Excel, normal Excel workbook. This does not save. This will not save your workbook, macro enabled workbook, as a normal. This will save it as a normal workbook. But this workbook contains a macro and I want to save it as a macro enabled workbook. So the following feature cannot be saved in macro free workbooks. This VB project or the VB editor or the VB code which I have written cannot be saved in a macro free workbook. To save a file with these features, click no. And then choose a macro enabled file type in the file type list. To continue saving it as a macro free workbook, click yes. So once I click yes, it will be saved as a macro free workbook. This means the next time you open this particular workbook, you'll not be able to run the macro, because you'll not get this particular macro there, because it has been stored as a non macro workbook. So for that, to save it as a macro enabled file, macro enabled workbook, I'll click on no. Once I click on no, you can just open this file type and you can select whichever way you want to save your document. I want to save it as a macro enabled workbook. So I'll click on Excel macro enabled workbook. As you all can see, this is the second option over here, which is the Excel enabled workbook. See, these are the various extensions on how I can save my normal Excel workbook. Here we are dealing with a macro enabled workbook, so we will save it as an Excel macro enabled workbook. Once I click on this and I'll click on save, yes, and so it has been stored as a macro enabled workbook. Once I go to my folder where I've stored all my objects, here you will see that it has been stored as a .xlsm, as you all can see, .xlsm, which is a mac, which is the type of the file, which is .xlsm. It is stored as a macro enabled workbook. XLSX is for Excel, normal Excel workbook. XLSM is for the macro enabled workbook, where the M stands for macros. And this is how you store your macro enabled workbook, where M stands for the macro. Thank you.